That bitch ain't talking about nothing. Fuck it. I changed my name, but I bet they still gon' find some. Y'all ain't bullying me out my shit. Draw hits, I still ain't miss. New money, new crib, new will, new name, I'm still that bitch. Only bitch from my city went platinum. Y'all know who the biggest is. Quick cap.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, as you can see by the title, it's going to be a Q&A. I'm shooting it on my phone because my camera is there. So if I like look over to the left a little bit, it's just because notifications be coming up on my phone. But I actually had to ask me some questions on Instagram and TikTok. I got like 15 questions on TikTok, and on Instagram, I got a lot of questions on Instagram. I'm not even gonna lie. I got hella questions on Instagram. So I'm just about to answer them for y'all. If y'all hear that sound, I need to change my smoke detector. It's so irritating, I'm sorry. But without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so the first question is, what are your favorite designer brands? My favorite designer brands would have to be Dior, Chanel, and Alexander Wang, because Chanel and Dior just give material girl. Like, even their old, like, their vintage pieces give material girl. Like, they just give. And then Alexander Wang, I don't really care to buy designer clothing. I'm more so like a bag and a shoe type of girl, but their clothes be cute. Like, Alexander Wang does his thing with the clothes. So those three brands probably be my favorite. Number two, what is your zodiac sign? I don't really believe in zodiac signs. I believe they just like a group of people. Capricorns, that's the only one I kind of, because I just know a whole bunch of mentally ill Capricorns. Other than that, I don't believe in zodiac signs, but according to people who are into that, I'm a Sagittarius. My favorite place I visited, I'm gonna just say Hawaii, because I just left Hawaii and it was so much fun. It was just a vibe, something that I needed, something that I've been wanting. So I'm just gonna say Hawaii. Something you've always wanted to do and somewhere you've always wanted to go but haven't yet. Something that I've always wanted to do was like make my own clothing brand, like my actual designs, go through an actual manufacturer, like hand pick everything like that. I haven't done that yet, but it's coming very, very soon. And a place I've wanted to go and I haven't yet would definitely be Greece. But in 2022, I plan on going there with my sister, well, my two sisters and her boyfriend. So hopefully that works out, but I'm like 99.9% sure that we're going to Greece. So yeah. Where are you from? I'm from Michigan, Detroit, Michigan. That's it, that's all. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? In 5 years, I see myself just stable, happy. Hopefully, I'm gonna be 26. So hopefully engaged, maybe a kid, I don't know. I don't really want kids like that, but hopefully engaged with a kid, bought my first house, living my dreams, my brand popped off, like just living like that girl. Well, I already live like that girl. So more like that girl, period. How tall are you? I'm gonna just say I'm 5 foot, because I've been saying 4'11 for forever. So I think I've grown an inch. I'm just gonna say I'm 5 foot. I'm really, really short, but it's okay. Age and hometown. Well, I just said hometown, but my age, I'm 21. Period. What is your biggest accomplishment? What is your biggest accomplishment so far? I would say my biggest accomplishment so far was moving to Los Angeles so young and getting to internship with Vera Wang. Even though the internship didn't last that long due to COVID, it was still a great experience and it was still a blessing to do so, because so many people don't get those type of opportunities, or people who already graduated college are doing those type of things. Like, it's really hard to get an internship with Vera Wang, Dior, Chanel. Like, that's very, very hard. So for me to have done that so young and to like just kept myself stable and kept myself there and pushing was such an accomplishment for me. I'm so proud of myself, and I'm only going farther. What is your dream job? I don't have a dream job. I don't want to work for nobody ever in my life. I just can't do it. I don't aspire to work for a certain company. I don't aspire to do any of that. Anything having to do with working for somebody. I don't have a dream job. I do have a dream career. I actually have two. My first dream career is to be a rich man's wife. Bro, okay. Seriously, though.
Hold on. What's the next thing?
Rachel, don't tell them.
Okay. So, my dream careers are... my dream job is to be a rich man's wife. Also, I want to be a rich wife to a rich man. And then I want to do something in the fashion industry. I'm still kind of deciding. I know for a fact I want to design, but even go higher, maybe be a buyer. Just, I don't really know. But definitely in the fashion industry for sure, 100%. I know that is my passion. That's where I'm headed is fashion for sure. Who are some people that inspire you? I got three like major inspirations outside of my mom and my dad. Like my dad has came from absolutely nothing, like homeless at 12, and just to see him become such like a man and like everything he's dreamed of, I don't know how to explain it, like just to see him grow from where we were till now is like major, like y'all don't even understand. And my mom, the same thing, to see her, well, I didn't really have to see her grow like that. She definitely has grown, but I have four older sisters, so they really experienced it. And then when I came, it was more like, okay, we're just gonna elevate. But she did come from, you know, not a hard life. My dad definitely had it harder, but just seeing them both grow and flourish and do what they love every single day, not have to work for anybody, is such a blessing to watch and see. So outside of my parents, I would definitely say my three inspirations are Nipsey Hussle, Rihanna, and Kamora Lee Simmons, because she is that girl. Like, who, if you're a fashion girl and you don't love Kamora Lee Simmons, what are you doing? Like, I don't understand that. I cannot wrap my head around that. Kamora Lee Simmons is that girl. She is my biggest inspiration in fashion, period, whatsoever. I love her so much. I love her work. I love her vision. I love her ideas. Everything about that woman, I love. I just love her. And then Rihanna, same thing. She is a girl when it comes to fashion. She is not afraid to step outside the box. She is assertive. She's straightforward. If she don't like it, she's not doing it. And that's kind of how I am. So I really look up to Rihanna. And then Nipsey Hussle. I liked his music, but I definitely looked up to him more on the business side of things, because I'm just such a business-minded person. I love to watch YouTube videos on business, how to expand business, how to grow a business, like just business things. It's definitely my lane. So just seeing him flourish in his company and watching him, like the moves that he made, PR moves, everything, he's a genius when it comes to this business stuff. I'm not playing. That man was a genius. Rest in peace to that man, period. Okay, who is my favorite rapper? My favorite rapper know who he is. He know he my favorite rapper. Next question. Why did you leave LA? I left LA. Well, I didn't permanently leave LA because I still have my apartment there. I'm just not there full time anymore because COVID in LA is next level. Also, I was so far from everybody, and I moved there with somebody, but they ended up having to leave. So when I moved there, like, I didn't really plan on being there by myself 100%, and I don't think I was like 1000% ready to just be on my own on top of COVID kicked in. So the Vera Wang internship just kind of fell apart, like everything kind of trickled down, and I was still maintaining, I was still good out there, but I was just kind of being by myself that far was kind of a lot for me, because especially with COVID going on and then LA itself, it was a lot. I was just really far. So if I don't have like any work, or I don't have to do a pool or do certain things in LA, I just don't be out there as much, but I still live there. Like, I still have a place there, if that makes sense. But COVID kind of took a big toll on LA, and it was kind of a lot for me. On top of that, I was hanging around some fake ass, weird ass bitches, And they used to have my, like, they just used to, I was hanging around the wrong people and they weren't keeping me focused. They had my head everywhere else. So I was everywhere but supposed to be in LA. So it was a lot of opportunities I can't say that I missed out on. Trying to be a down friend to these people. But you know, you live and you learn. I'm still gonna get, hold on. I'm still gonna get opportunities. I'm still growing. I'm still learning. I'm still young, so I'm not tripping. For your relationship status, my relationship status is none of your business. Period. Okay, the next question is my favorite TV show and my favorite movie. I got four favorite movies. My favorite movies are Daddy's Little Girl, Think Like a Man, ATL, and Matilda. And then my favorite show, I don't have a favorite TV show. Well, Kimora Life in the Fab Lane, of course, but that been went off. So outside of that, I'm just going to say Power because that's the only show I really watch. And I watch BMF, but I wouldn't consider that my favorite show. But so I'm just going to say Power and The Chi. The Chi is one of my favorite shows too, but that went off too. What is my favorite food? Lamb chops, probably. It used to be crab legs, but I overate crab legs. I don't even like them no more because I just ate them so much. So I'm just going to say lamb chops, wings, and fries, and pasta. Your best advice you've been given. The best, if I, and then the second question is the hardest lesson you've had to learn at your age. I'm just going to tie those two in together. So the best advice is watch who you hang around and watch the people you surround yourself with. And the hardest lesson that I had to learn was watching who I surround myself with and the people around, because people don't genuinely care about you. They are mentally ill. They're mentally retarded. They're mentally gone in the head. I'm dead serious. My sister's in the background. She's laughing, but I'm dead serious. People are mentally challenged. And they are so well, they're so good at hiding it. And then when they get mad or when something comes out, then they show their true colors. So you just gotta watch the people that you're around, because the energy that they project on you is so real. Like, you literally have to watch that, because if they're a bum bitch, I'm gonna mute that. If they're a bum, you're gonna eventually start coming up with bum habits. Like, not last summer, I used to hang out with the wrong people, and I was doing stuff that I didn't even do. Like, I'm not really a party club type of girl. I was at the club all the time. I was drinking all the time. Like, that wasn't even me prior to all of this. So just watching the people that you surround yourself with, because people be undercover haters. They don't really want to see you win unless it's with them. And even with them, if they feel like their life is going down, then they're definitely going to drag you down with them. So make sure you have the right people around you. Describe your dream home and car. My dream home is like a modern, all glass, like huge upstairs, downstairs closet, fat island in the kitchen. Like, I want to live in Texas though. So like, when I get my dream home, it's definitely going to be in Texas or LA. So just be on the lookout, because I'm probably still going to be doing this when I'm buying my dream house. Swear to me, because y'all are the ones that's gonna provide it. Nah, for real, but my dream home, I'm gonna insert a picture of like an idea of what I want my dream home to look like. Like, spiral staircase when I walk in the house, like just luxury, big, just everything big. My dream car is a Bentley and a lamb truck. So we gonna see if we can make that happen within the next 2 years. I definitely want a Bentley and I want a lamb truck. I want a black Bentley with red guts, and I want a blue or white lamb truck with like whatever color the truck is. I want the trimming and the Lamborghini to be that color. So we gonna manifest that, period. Okay, then those are my questions from TikTok. I'm about to go look on Instagram and see. So I got hella questions on Instagram. So, a skill you wish you had, and if you could time travel. A skill I wish I had, I wish I could do hair. I really wish I could do hair. Y'all, I can't even do my own edges. Like, I look like I just be looking a mess all the time. Like, I literally wish that I could do hair, or I wish I could sing or rap, because I would be talking my, yeah, like I would be like Nicki Minaj, like, not playing. Like, I would literally, y'all could not pick with me when it comes to rapping if I could rap. If you could change one thing about yourself, what would it be? It's something that I can change. Do I want to change it? Not yet, but I'm definitely going to change it in the future. But how impulsive I am. If I get mad, I'm going to hop on a plane. If I get mad, I'm going to move to a different state. If I get mad enough, I'm just going to leave. Like, I just leave. Like, because I know I can, so I'm just going to leave. So definitely how impulsive I am. I could be very, very impulsive. Or even when I get mad, because I can't stay mad long. But when I get mad in that moment, I'm going to do too much. Sometimes I don't know how to keep my hands to myself. Like, just stuff like that. I can definitely... basically leave me alone. Definitely stuff like that. Like, just being impulsive and not thinking in the moment. And just knock you in your... like, just something like that. Okay. Ideal relaxing day for you. Sleep, a crab bag, and power. Or going to get my, like, pamper myself. Going to get a massage, going to get my hair done, my nails done, my lashes done. Going to get my hair done, my nails done, my lashes done. Just pampering myself. Or sleep. Because I really like to sleep.
We know.
My dream internship, I really don't have a dream internship because, like I said, I don't, like, really want to work with nobody. So, like, I don't really care the internship because I don't want to work for y'all, you know? But
basically, I just want to wear Lululemon.
I just want to wear Lululemon and get coffee in the morning, take my kids to school on the lamp trip, basically. But no, I'm going to say dream collaboration. I want to collab with Kamora Lee Simmons. I want to collab with Dior. Like, stuff like that. I would do a collaboration with my brand and their brand, or me featuring, like, have a collection in their brand. But, like, internship, I'm good on that. Can I be your friend?
Yeah.
Hey, friend. I already answered that. How many kids do you want in the future? I want the max kids to the minimum kids, 0. But I want a boy and a girl. I'm not gonna tell y'all their names because y'all gonna steal them. So, yeah. Okay, this is the last question. The last question is, what is a perfect date for you? Chanel. Simple. Take me to Chanel. Take me to the mall. Let me splurge. Take me to sex. Take me to demons. I really don't care. As long as I'm going to the mall, just take me to the mall. That's my dream ideal date. So if you wanna take me on a date ever in life, if you ever even get the chance to, take me on a date. If it's not the mall, I don't want to go. I want to go to the mall. I want to go to the mall. I want to shop. We could get some food too. I don't like those upscale restaurants. I'm not
me
that type of
either. Woman.
You want to be in the video?
No, I don't like them either. I hate upscale.
I don't want to go to Real Ruth Chris. It's only not like the good. Two upscale restaurants that I like: Fleming's and STK. Other than that, I don't want to go. Yes. Do not take me to Ruth Chris. I don't care about that lobster mac. It's not that good. I don't care about the stuffed chicken. Like, I can make that at home. Like, I can cook, for real. So, I don't care about none of this. Don't take me to no upscale restaurant. Take me to the hood where the food truck's at, where the good food at. Take me to the hood on the block where the good food at. I don't want to go to the upscale. Like, I don't care about stuff like that. I like date nights. Like, when you go into restaurants. But take me to a lounge where we're going to actually get some good food with seasoning and it tastes good. Like, I don't care trying to be bougie and limit jobs. And, like, no, I don't care about that. Take me to the good, please. But other than that, those are other questions. Thank y'all for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And in the comments below, comment down what y'all want me to do next, what y'all want to see next. Period. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Did I just say that? Make sure you follow me on all my social medias. One Real Rach on TikTok, The Real _ RACHH on Instagram, and Twitter is One Real Rach as well. Thank you guys so much. Love y'all.
A bitch ain't talking about nah, fuck it. I changed my name, but I bet they still gon' find some. Y'all ain't bully me out my shit. Draw hits, I still ain't miss. New money, new crib, new will, new name, I'm still that bitch. Only bitch from my city went platinum. Y'all know who the biggest is, quick cap.